Hello, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to change the WordPress table prefix. If you're running a WordPress site, it's important to keep your database secure. One way to do this is by changing the default table prefix. In this video, I'll show you how to change the WordPress table prefix in just a few steps. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, here are some things you need to consider before changing your WordPress table prefix. First, you need to make sure that you back up your WordPress database. This way, if anything goes wrong during the process, you can quickly restore your site. Second, you need to be aware that changing the WordPress table prefix may break any existing plugins or themes that are currently active on your site. This is because they're all stored in the database under the current table prefix. So, if you do decide to change the WordPress table prefix, you'll need to deactivate and then reactivate any existing plugins and themes. Third, changing the prefix won't stop all hackers if they are already able to exploit your site with SQL injections. But it will stop bot attacks, which are the bulk of hacking attempts. Fourth, the prefix set in your wp-config.php folder and the one used in your actual database must be the same, and every table needs to use the same prefix or your site will break. It's easy to break your site by doing this, so you shouldn't if you don't know what you're doing. And lastly, if you work in the database often, queries you find online use the default prefix, so changing it can be annoying. Remember, back up your site and database, as changing the table prefix could break your entire site if done wrong. A backup will mean you can restore your site from that point should an error occur. The first method we'll discuss involves using FTP to directly change the wp-config.php file. We prefer using MyKinsta for this task. Here's how to do it. Once you're logged in, click on Sites in the left sidebar and then select the site you want to change the prefix for. Then click Info. Scroll down to the section called SFTP SSH and copy the information there, including the host, username, password, and port. Now you need to use this information to log in to an FTP client. We recommend using FileZilla. Once you've installed it, open the app and enter the information from MyKinsta into the fields for host, username, password, and port. Then click Quick Connect. Alternatively, you can easily complete steps 1 and 2 via cPanel as well by logging into your hosting account, accessing the cPanel, then going to File Manager. After you've logged in, you should see a list of files on the right side. Find the wp-config.php file and download it to your computer by right-clicking on it and selecting Download from the menu. Now open the wp-config file in a text editor like Sublime Text. Find the line that says this, and change the WP to the new prefix you want to use. Make sure to save the file when you're done. Now go back to FileZilla and find the wp-config file on your computer. Right-click on it and select Upload from the menu. The next step is to actually change the prefix for all the WordPress tables in your database. Here are the default prefixes. You should also pay attention to database tables outside of the defaults that plugins created as well. To change the prefix, you need to access your database. You can do this via phpMyAdmin in cPanel. Or you can once again use MyKinsta for this task, which provides direct database access. Log into your account, navigate to Sites, Your Site, and then Info, and click on the link that says Open phpMyAdmin. Click on the database name in the left sidebar. Then click on the SQL tab at the top of the page. In this text box, enter this query. Of course, you need to replace new prefix with your actual new prefix. For instance, if you were changing the database prefix for WP comments, it would appear as new prefix underscore comments after you make the change. Then click the Go button. Repeat this process for all the WordPress tables in your database, changing WP to your new prefix. You can search the options and user meta tables for the old prefix to ensure you've changed and updated everything. The next step is to deactivate all plugins and themes. You need to do this because the plugins and themes were installed using the old prefix and will need to be refreshed, so to speak, using the new prefix. You can do this by going to the plugins and themes pages in your WordPress admin dashboard. Once all the plugins and themes are deactivated, reactivate them one by one to ensure they work properly under the new database prefix. Once you've changed the prefix for all your WordPress tables in your database, you can test your WordPress site to make sure everything is working properly. To do that, simply visit your WordPress site in a web browser. If it loads without any errors, then you're good to go. You can also use a tool like Kinsta APM to conduct continual performance monitoring to ensure your site's performance remains in tip-top shape. If you're not comfortable working with code or accessing your database directly, then you can also use a plugin to change the prefix. We recommend the BrosmeDB Prefix and Tools add-ons plugin for this task. First, you need to install and activate the plugin. You can do this from the WordPress admin area by going to Plugins and then Add New and searching for the BrosmeDB Prefix and Tools add-ons. Once you've found it, click Install Now and then Activate. Now that the plugin is activated, you can change the WordPress database prefix by going to Tools and then DB Prefix. On this page, you need to enter your new database prefix in the new prefix field. Then click the Change DB Prefix button. The plugin will now update all of your WordPress tables with the new prefix. After the plugin has updated your database, you can test your WordPress site to make sure it's still functional. As before, open your web browser and navigate to your live site. If everything looks as it should, the update worked. If you don't want to use a plugin, then you can also change the WordPress database prefix using Adminner. Adminner is a standalone PHP script that allows you to manage your databases. To get started with Adminner, you'll need to download the latest version from the official website. Once you have it, you need to upload this PHP file to your website's root server. You can do this via FTP using a tool like FileZilla. Once Adminner is uploaded, you can access it directly via your web browser. The latest version is 4.8.1, so if you've placed it in your site's root directory, you can access it by going to this URL. From here, you can access and log in to any database on your server. However, we only want to change the WordPress database prefix so you can ignore all the other databases. On this page, select your WordPress database from the left sidebar, then click on the SQL command tab at the top of the page. In the text box, enter this query. Of course, you need to replace new prefix with your actual new prefix. For instance, if you're changing the database prefix for WP user meta, it would appear as new prefix underscore user meta after you make the change. Then click the execute button. Repeat that process for all of the WordPress tables in your database, changing WP to the new prefix of your choosing. After you've updated the prefix for all of your WordPress tables in your database, you may test your website to ensure that everything is functioning properly. Simply go to your WordPress site in a web browser and see whether it loads without any issues. If all is well, you're all done. Congratulations, you successfully changed the WordPress database prefix and updated your site accordingly. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started, and thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.